Waalaikumsalam
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi
warahmatullahi
wabarakatuh.
wabarakatuh. Hi everyone.
Hai.
Hi. Hi.
Hai.
So,
Halo.
my name is Natasha and I'm going to be your tutor in the next month. So, ini dari mana aja ya? Ini dari banyak kota nih. Ada
dari
yang
Bandung,
SMP,
Kak.
SMA?
Saya dari Depok.
Hai.
Dari Ambon, Kak.
Hai, dari Ambon.
Dari Bekasi. Besar, Kak.
Hai, Kak.
Are you ready?
Halo,
dari
Kak.
Dari Bekasi. Dari Jakarta, Kak.
Okay, today I will be your speaking tutor. And welcome to the first lesson of speaking class. Jadi hari ini kita akan belajar tentang greeting and introduction. Dan di kelas aku nanti kalian bisa tanya di tengah-tengah aku presentasi nanti. And maybe we will have some discussion related to the topic, okay? Okay.
Orang
share-nya masuk ya.
Guru ya, guru.
Guru.
Masuk ke
Yes, I see.
Okay. The first lesson is about greeting and self introduction. So I'm going to teach you on how to greet someone and introduce yourself as well. Jadi nanti kalian bisa praktis di sini dan nanti kita sama-sama say hi with English, okay? Jadi, I want to give a quote here. The minute that you're not learning, I believe you'll get by Jack Nicholson. Means that we have to learn because if we're not learning, we will die and we will not have a knowledge to face the world. So let's talk about greeting. Nah, di sini kalian mungkin ada beberapa gimana sih caranya menyapa orang, how to greet someone. Nah, ini contohnya contoh greetings itu sendiri. You can say hi, hello, good morning, menanyakan kabar like how are you doing, and maybe some of you still don't know how to respond this, and I will give you some example here. For example, if we say hi, we can say hello, good morning, we can say good morning. And if someone ask kabar kalian, kalian bisa bilang, I'm fine, thank you. Nah, sekarang aku mau tanya, bedanya how are you sama how do you do apa? Kan how are you itu sama how do you do sama. Tapi bedanya apa sih?
Kalau how do you do untuk orang yang baru ketemu bukan, Kak?
Jadi, how do you do itu, aku nambahin dikit ya, how do you do itu buat orang, kalau kalian ketemu orang, tapi kalian tuh lama sekali gak ketemu. You can use how do you do. Kalau how are you tuh ya, kalau kalian ini kenal sama orang, tapi ya kenal, tapi masih ketemu gitu loh. Kalau how do you do ini lama banget kok gak ketemu. Lama gak ketemu. So, next. So, this is on how you introduce yourself. Okay, aku mau nyoba ya. My name is Natasha. My full name is Natasha Ilsasabila. My nickname is Natasha. Or kalian bisa pakai, you can call me Tasha, misal. Dan untuk mengawali itu, kalian bisa pakai ini. Let me. You can say hello first. Hello. Good morning. Menyapa audiens dulu. Terus kalian bilang, let me introduce myself. My name is siapa. Atau kalian bisa pakai, first of all, I would like to introduce myself. Di sini ada nggak yang mau nyoba? Please introduce yourself. Aku juga pengen tahu di antara orang sebanyak ini. Ada yang mau coba? Ya. Ada yang mau coba nggak? Ada?
Ya.
Saya, Kak.
Sedih. Nggak ada? Ada yang mau coba?
Alicia, Kak.
Oke, okay, Alicia, hai.
Hello everyone. Good evening. Good afternoon. Let me introduce myself. My name is Alicia. My full name is Alicia Putri Apriliani. My nickname is Alicia. Thank you.
Thank you, Alicia. Ada lagi yang mau coba?
Saya terima, Kak.
Boleh.
Siapa yang mau, Kak?
Saya mau, Kak.
Saya mau, Kak.
Saya mau, Kak.
Oh. Cowok aja, Kak. Saya, Kak.
Oke, oke. Terus itu ya?
Yoi. Yoi, Kak. Sudah bisa dimulai?
Boleh. Silakan.
Good afternoon. Hello everyone. My name is Kadek Dwi Restu Wijaya. My full name is Kadek Dwi Restu Wijaya. My nickname is Restu.
Kamu dari Bali ya?
Ya, ya, Kak.
Salam kenal, Restu.
Ya, i.
Ada kasih, lagi?
Kak.
Nisa, boleh coba enggak, Kak?
Boleh.
Okay. Hello, everyone. Let me introduce myself. My name is Nisa. My full name is Anisa Azura. My nickname is Nisa. Okay.
Thank you, Nisa. Okay, let's go to the next.
Saya mau, Kak.
Okay, siapa itu? Priska.
Hah?
Siapa? Tadi yang bersuara siapa ya?
Kak, saya mau, Kak.
Nabila, Kak, mau, Kak.
Oke.
Saya mau, Kak.
Nabila, oke.
Okay. Hello, everyone. My name is Nabila. My full name is Nabila Saskia Tagus. My nickname is Nabila.
Oke, okay, thank you, Nabila.
Yes.
Oke, okay, next ya. So, dari beberapa tadi teman kalian sudah ngenalin diri mereka masing-masing. Nah, kalian bisa jawab perkenalan mereka dengan "Hai Nabila, I'm glad to meet you. Nice to meet you, Restu." Kayak gitu. Oke. Okay? Next. Nah, ini caranya kalian mengenalkan orang lain. Jadi, di perkenalan kalian tidak hanya tidak hanya mengenalkan diri kalian sendiri, tapi juga mengenalkan orang lain. For example, hi, this is my friend. Her name is Alicia, for example. This is a friend of mine. Dia ini temanku, kayak gitu. Mungkin kalian ada nggak yang mau nih ngenalin teman kalian? Yang belum tadi, you may
gimana?
Introduce others. Yang belum speaking tadi, yang belum nyoba, ada yang mau nyoba? Or maybe we can go to the next slide. Jadi itu ya contohnya how to introduce others. Kalian bisa kenalin teman kalian atau orang tua kalian ke orang lain. Next. Nah, ini respon contoh-contohnya. Hi, glad to meet you. I'm Oki. Nice to meet you all, guys. I'm Natasha. Or it's nice to see you today. Okay. Jadi, di greeting itu pasti ada pembukaan hi dan pasti ada leaving, berpisah, ya kan? Nah, di situ kalian ini, kalian pasti mengucapkan salam. Udah dulu ya, bye-bye. Nah, ini adalah contoh-contoh kalimat untuk mengucapkan perpisahan. All right, everyone, it's time to head off. Nice to see you. Have a good day. Itu untuk mengakhiri percakapan. Nah, di ini, di bahasa Inggris juga ada salam perpisahan, tapi dengan slang. Slang language, for example, take care, bye. Later, man or bro, catch you later. Peace, peace out, smell you later. Jadi kalian bisa pakai ini di situasi yang tidak formal. Mungkin kalian punya sahabat dekat banget kan, bisa bilang later sis, later bro, or catch you later. Ya. Yeah. So far any question?
No.
No.
No. Okay. Nah, let's practice. Ada yang mau nyoba antara Rama sama Cinta ini?
Mau, Kak.
Siap.
Mau, Kak.
Mau, Kak.
Ya, mau, Kak. Tapi sama namanya Cindy.
Apa? Oke, yang belum itu Aulia. Aulia, kamu mau?
Mau, Kak.
Aulia sama, aku pilih deh, sama Rima.
Oke, Kak.
Oke, Aulia sama Rima. Siapa yang mau jadi Rama?
Aulia aja deh.
Yaudah, Aulia Rama ya. Oke, you may start now.
Hello, I am Rama.
Hi, I am Sinta.
Nice to meet you, Sinta.
Nice to meet you too. To where do you stay?
I stay at Hotel Indonesia. Kempinski in Jalan Tamrin.
Our hotels are across the street from each other. I stay at Grand Hyatt Hotel.
How will you go to the meeting tomorrow?
Rima, you may answer.
Saya kan Sinta.
Iya, tadi ini si Aulia sudah bilang how will you go to the meeting tomorrow?
I will take a taxi.
I drive my car. We can go together to tomorrow meeting.
That's a good idea. I will wait for you in front of the hotel at 9 a.m.
Great. See you tomorrow.
See you.
Thank you, Rima, Aulia. So guys, this is the example of conversation. Jadi di situ ada meeting pembukaan, terus isi percakapan, lalu diakhiri dengan leaving. Karena akhirnya Rima dan Cinta ini berpisah. See you tomorrow, see you. Okay, next. Okay, sekarang aku pengen tahu dari kalian, because this is speaking class, I want you guys to speak more. And I have some questions here. Where is your dream country and why? And if you have difficulties in speaking, I will help you. Ada mau coba? Kalian mesti punya kan mimpi mau kemana, ke negara mana, mungkin ke Amerika, ke Inggris. Atau mungkin ke...
Saya ada.
Ada yang mau coba? Ada yang mau coba?
Alicia.
Saya. Okay. Okay, Alicia. What? Where is your dream country?
My dream country is Korea.
Wow. Why?
I want to kuliah there. Yes.
I want to study there.
Yeah.
I want to study there, and because the weather is so nice.
Do you want to see snow in Korea?
What?
Do you want to see snow in Korea?
Yeah.
Everyone want to know snow, right?
Right. Yeah, and I want to meet with Opa.
sure. There's a lot of Opa in Korea. Thank you, Alicia.
Yeah.
Ada yang mau lagi?
What question?
Okay, Minir, where is your dream country?
Yes. What question?
Where is your dream country?
My dream country is Los Angeles, America Serikat.
Wow, why?
Yes, because Los Angeles, America Serikat is the country destroyed technology and smart technology because college in their America Serikat because smart people and anything.
Yeah, okay, thank you. Okay. I do agree with you because Los Angeles have a lot of smart people, and if you want to study there, they have a good study model. Thank you, Mindis. Yes. Anyone else? Okay.
Saya kak,
boleh coba.
Okay, aku mau. Saya kak.
Okay, Dias. Where is your dream country?
My dream country is Japan.
Wow, Japan. Why?
Because I want to study here, and I want to continue my major.
What's your major?
RPL.
Oh.
Program.
What is RPL?
Coding. Coding of program.
Oh, I see. That's good. Okay, thank you, Dias. Anyone else?
Thank you.
Saya, Kak. Boleh coba, Kak?
Kita sharing-sharing.
Ayo, siapa? Saya kali, Kak.
Aku mau. Boleh coba, Kak, di sini.
Saya, Kak.
Saya aja, Kak.
Aku nggak bisa di sini loh, kalian.
Oke, Maria.
Oke, makasih kesempatannya, Kak. Hello, everyone. Here I'm Alfi. I want to share to you all about my dream country. Here I want to go to India. Why? Because I have several friends that come from India. That's why I want to meet with them again one day if I have opportunity to go to the country. And I want also try their foods and I want to try when they have some festival there. I want to try how the feel of their festival. So that's why I want to go India one day. Thank you.
Thank you. You say that you have friend in India. So where do you meet your friend? Your India's friend.
I ever joined some program called ISAC. That's why I can meet them.
I see.
Yeah. In their program, I'll be a local volunteer and my friends become an international volunteer, so we can meet them and have a project in Bandung.
Oh, that's good. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you.
Ada lagi?
Let me change.
We have a lot of dreams here, right? Ada yang mau coba lagi?
Please give me chance.
Okay.
Yeah.
Sure. Yang tadi siapa tadi? Please give me chance. Okay.
Aku Nisa. Okay.
Okay, Nisa.
Guys, I'm wanna go into London in Bali. In Greece.
United Kingdom.
Yeah. Because I want to study in here, in there.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm very, very, very love this country. Okay.
Mm. Okay, thank you. Or we can, yeah?
Ada
aku lagi?
Novia.
Yes, Novia, you may start, please.
I will share my dream country. I will stay in the USA because I will scholarship in there and I like culture in the USA. Thank you.
Thank you, Novia. Or we can change this topic. This is where is your dream country? I will change to what is your dream? Yang belum coba yuk, coba yuk. What is your
saya,
dream?
Kak.
I know we you guys have a lot of dreams here. Siapa itu? Okay, Michael.
Hello everyone. I have a dream to make a big contribution for Indonesia in technology sector because today I have studying about data science and in the future I want to study in the Binus University. From that I will make a connection to other people want to make a big contribution for Indonesia.
Wow. That's a good dream. Thank you, Michael, for sharing.
Yes.
Anyone else? Anyone else? Siapa yang mau coba lagi? Ada lagi? Prima? Oh tidak. Okay. If jika nggak ada, kita next ya. Okay, next. So thank you everyone for sharing your dream country and also your dream. I hope we can reach our dream together. Okay.
Amin.
So next, please answer this. I know we have I know we want to know each other, and in order to know that, we have to talk. We have to talk everything. Like for example, about our dream, about our habit, and about what we like. Maybe some of you want to share what you like. What's your favorite? I give mine first. My favorite number is 8, and my favorite food is fried rice. My yes, yes. My dream country is Australia because I want to see snow there and I want to continue my study there. My hobby is reading a book such as novel, fiction, vision novel, and I was born in Semarang on July 29, 2000. Ada yang mau coba?
Coba kak.
Saya okay, kak. Coba kak.
Aku mau coba kak.
Saya kak. Saya kak.
Teresa,
ayo.
Teresa,
ayo. Iya, aku.
Okay.
So, my favorite number is 27. My favorite food is Italian dish. My dream country is Japan because I would like to see the view. Such as like Fuji Mountains and Sakura flowers. And my hobbies is listening to music, watching some movies and playing guitar.
Oh, you can play guitar.
Yes. And then place and date of birth. I was born in Yogyakarta on March 27, 2004. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you, Teresa. Anyone else?
Aku mau coba, Kak.
Wina, coba, Kak.
Coba.
Aku mau coba, Kak.
Fitri.
Ya, Kak. My favorite number is 7. My favorite food is chicken. And my dream country is US. Because I wanna study abroad. I think US is a good country to study. My hobbies is listening to music and dancing. And okay. Place and date in birth, Depok, November 17, 2004. Thank you.
Thank you, Vitri. Anyone else?
Wina, Kak.
Wait, let me see.
Wina, Kak.
Carlin.
Yeah. My favorite number is 10. My favorite food is fried chicken. My dream country is Korea.
Why?
Yeah. My favorite number is 10. My favorite food is fried chicken. My dream country is Korea because Korea is a big country and it's a wonderful country. I would like to meet some oppa. My hobbies is singing, dancing, and read some novels. My place and date of birth is Omere, May 10, 2002. Thank you.
Thank you, Carlin. Anyone else?
Saya mau coba, Kak.
Alisa.
My favorite number is 11. My favorite food is black. My dream country is Korea because I want to continue my study. My hobby is listening music. I was born in Bandung. 11 April 1999.
Okay, thank you. Anyone else?
What's
the right?
Jessica.
Putri.
Oh yeah. My favorite number is 24. My favorite food is fried noodle. My dream country is Korea because I want to watch EXO concert live. My hobby is singing and painting. Place and date of birth. Wait.
Kamu lupa ulang tahun berapa?
Enggak. 14 Bali January 20, 2007.
Oke. Okay. Yeah. Thank you, Jessica.
Ya.
Yeah. Ada lagi?
Saya kak.
Halo, Agus. Halo?
Kakak. Halo?
Hah? Yumeis, ya?
Halo?
Ya? Agus?
Alicia, Kak.
Oh, Alicia, siapa gimana?
Hadir.
Saya.
Apa ini, Kak?
Amara, Kak. Agus? Agus, are you there?
Yes, I'm there.
I'm here. Okay.
Okay.
You may start now.
Okay, thank you, Kak. My favorite number is 8 because in mathematics, if we rotate the number, is the meaning of infinity. Okay. My favorite food is lawar. Yes, lawar. And my dream country is Japan because I have one idol who motivated me in video on YouTube. The name of idol is Jeremy Pullin. So he really motivated me. And my hobby is playing game and exercise. I was born in Denpasar. I was born in Denpasar, 31st March 2004. Thank you.
Thank you. By the way, Agus, I also fan of Jerome. I don't know.
Mantap, Bu.
Saya, Kak. Yes. Next. Fatima Zara.
Lisa. Wina, Kak.
Aulia, Kak.
Sofia, Kak.
Amara, Kak.
Wina, Kak.
Kak,
Alicia. Oh, saya, Kak.
Fatima Zara. Oke, okay. Tenang-tenang, guys. Nanti habis ini ada lagi kok.
What is your favorite number? Seven. My favorite food, chocolate. And your dream country, Cambridge, because I will want to study in Cambridge University. My hobby is reading. The last, what is your place? Surabaya City, and date of birth, 18 November. Thank you.
Thank you. Oh yeah, guys, aku mau ngasih gambaran sedikit. So I heard your speaking and it's a good. Tapi ini aku mau ada highlight beberapa. Jadi untuk plural sama singular. If your hobby is one, you have to use is. And if your hobby more than one, you have to use are. Because kalau satu kan itu singular. Kalau dua itu, dua atau lebih itu kan plural. Nah, ini nanti akan dijelaskan di ini, di grammar class next week. Jadi gitu ya, masukan aku. But you've done a good job. Ada lagi?
Saya, Kak.
Aku, Kak. Alicia.
Wina, Kak.
Saya, Kak.
Saya, Kak. Saya juga ada Wina, Kak.
Makasih, Kak.
Marah, Kak.
Alicia.
Wina, Kak.
Alicia, Kak.
Marah, Kak.
Wina.
Kak Onsa, Kak.
Wina.
Wina.
Marah, Kak.
Saya aja,
Kak. Oke.
Makasih, Kak.
Aku, Kak.
Saya, Mara, Kak.
Wina.
Okay. My favorite number is 4. My favorite food is fried rice. My dream country is Japan because I want to see cherry blossom. My hobbies are listening music and reading some comic. Place and date of birth. Denpasar on the 14th of February 2003. Thank you.
Thank you. Next, we have another, and you have another. I have another question. Wait. Ini ya dari aku sendiri. What do you think about English? Let's practice, guys. What do you think about English?
I think
Alvin is so hard.
English is funny.
English mm-hmm. is hard.
Why?
Funny.
English so cool.
Why? Why English language is so cool for you?
You can't talk with stranger, maybe. I think that.
Mm-hmm. Lisa?
I think English so hard because I get that score in English.
Mm-hmm. What else? Ada yang mau jawab lagi?
English is a way to communicate with people all over the country.
Mm-hmm. Good. Then, what else?
English is international language.
Yes. Anyone just say it.
English is complicated, miss. Since
Why?
We have to learn since we have to learn how grammar works and how to pronounce some words correctly, I think.
Yes. Sometimes I feel that too. And then ada yang mau share their opinion about English.
Learning so, English can okay. help you with the new people.
Yeah, sure. What else? Alicia, Putri, what do you think about English?
When I learn English, it's so funny.
Mm-hmm.
And I can catch when people talk with English, but I'm so confused if I answer.
Okay, yes. Thank you. Anyone else? Anyone else? You may share your opinion here.
For me, English is a bit confusing because like when you're doing exam, sometimes there is questions that have a trap. It's a trap, like you it must like how ya kayak soal jebakan gitu loh kak.
I see.
Sometimes it's a bit confusing, so I think I have to study more about it.
Yes, thank you. Anyone else?
Aku bisa. Apa yang orang ngomongin tapi nggak bisa ngomong ya.
Okay. I heard some of you say that English is difficult and also English is sometimes like complicated, especially for speaking. What I want to say is that if we want to master speaking, number one, we have to practice more. If we have sessions like this, you may start and try to speak. Because jadi gini, kalau misalnya ada juga orang yang lancar bahasa Inggris, tapi kalau misalnya lama nggak latihan juga akhirnya kaku juga speakingnya. And maybe some of you also is not confident with speaking since we have to think about grammar, we have to think what we have to say. But I encourage you to talk everything. Please don't mind about grammar first. Build your own confidence first to speak. Nah, if you already have your confidence in speaking English, you can use your grammar. You can use your grammar because I've been there and I saw all of my friends. They are not confident with English since they don't know the grammar. And in the end, they are not speak English anymore. Jadi gitu ya guys. Please try to speak. Like maybe you can train yourself. Mungkin ngomong sendiri. Mungkin share your opinion with English. I hope dengan itu kita juga terbiasa. Jadi setelah misal kelas ini selesai, kalian masih bisa melatih diri kalian sendiri, oke?
Okay?
Oke. Okay, next.
Okay.
So we learn about everything here. We share our dreams here. But I want you to know what we have learned today. Kita belajar apa sih? Kita sharing tentang apa sih? Who wants to speak? Hello? What we have learned today?
I have learned how to speak with stranger.
Mm-hmm. And then?
I've learned how.
And then?
Things that we can say to people when we are introducing ourselves, maybe.
Mm-hmm. That's true. And then?
Okay, I learned to speak English like introducing myself.
Mm-hmm. Yes, that's true.
Okay, I want to answer this question. So last time, we have learned about, the first is we learned about how to introduce ourselves in front of people and then how to respond it. After that, we learned about how to introduce our friends to the other people and then also how to respond it. And then we are sharing our opinion about what is our favorite number, food, and then what is our dream countries, and then our tanggal lahir, I'm sorry, and then the last is we sharing our opinion about what is English. That's it.
Okay, thank you. Anyone else? After this, we have Q&A session and also sharing session. And then? What do you get?
Ngajem.
Ada yang mau coba lagi? Guys? Alia, Nurina ya?
Apa kak?
What do you learn today?
I learned to speak English, such as introducing myself in front of people.
Okay, thank you. Anyone else? Anissa, Azura? Maybe?
I don't know.
If no, the next session is Q&A. Ada yang mau bertanya? tentang
saya
ini ya. Coba tadi.
I wanna ask you about accent. You know, like there are a lot of accent in English as well. Is accent really important to learn?
Oh.
Apakah belajar aksen itu penting atau enggak?
Same. Ya. Yeah. Oke. Okay. Sama mau nanya itu juga.
Oke. Okay. Thank you for the question. I think in my opinion, aksen is sometimes important because what? Because why? Because we know that British accent, Australian accent is when you see British people and Australian people talk, it's hard to understand, right?
Yeah, exactly.
Yes, yeah, exactly. So that's why I think learning accent is important to understand those people. Want. Okay, gitu. But I think in learning accent is also process. Jadi
pelan-pelan juga.
Ya. Jadi pelan-pelan juga belajar accentnya. Maybe it's important to understand them. I think itu.
Okay, thank you very much.
Ada pertanyaan lagi? Mungkin ada yang mau curhat. Aku susah kak belajar ini, kenapa ya? Itu mungkin ada, or maybe, ya, Hadis ya, Hadis Ayu.
Iya kak.
Cara bisa memperbaiki Inggris, soalnya grammarnya tuh salah waktu ngomong kata-kata.
I'm sorry Hadis, aku nggak bisa dengar suaramu. Bisa diulangi nggak?
Itu kak, gimana cara biar bisa belajar dia? Benar, soalnya sering kali waktu buat kalimat itu salah grammarnya. Cara kita buat belajar grammar gitu loh kak.
Oh oke, okay. Jadi ini the key of success to master English adalah banyak latihan. Because grammar is also same with speaking. Jadi grammar itu kan ada tuh ya rumus-rumusnya. Nah itu kan biar kita mengingat tata kalimat yang benar, tata percakapan yang benar, itu memang harus praktis. Jadi harus sering-sering buka rumusnya, harus sering-sering latihan soalnya. Jadi di proses belajar itu nanti, you can do that. Memang learning English, we have to practice more about that. Jadi gitu, kalau ada grammar-grammar salah, harus banyak latihan lagi. Jadi banyak latihan, nanti kalian tuh akan terbiasa, oh, for example ya, kalau misalnya grammar, kalian nemu soal, oh, kalian nanti kok misalnya banyak latihan, kalian bisa tahu, oh, ini pasti simple past, oh, ini pasti present tense, kayak gitu. And the next meeting, ada grammar class, I recommend you to join that. Ada lagi yang mau bertanya?
Kak, saya mau bertanya.
Ya.
Kak, kenapa ya saya kalau berbicara bahasa Inggris itu tiba-tiba itu kayak gagap gitu loh kak. Kayak gagap. Tapi kalau waktu nulis lancar. Terima kasih kak.
Cuy.
Yes. People's problem are hard to speak rather than write sometimes. Nah itu pertama we have to question ourselves first. Kalian itu pede enggak sebenarnya? Mungkin kadang alasan karena gagap, satu, kalian enggak percaya diri. Kedua, emang kalian nervous karena mungkin enggak tahu mau jawab apa, kalian enggak tahu mau tanya apa misalnya. Iya kan, sebenarnya problemnya kayak gitu. Nah, untuk menghindari gagap itu, first you have to build your own confidence. Yang aku bilang tadi bahwa jangan berpikir tentang grammar dulu. Bangun kepercayaan diri kalian untuk speaking bahasa Inggris dulu, baru nanti lambat laun dalam berproses itu kita bakal belajar tentang speaking yang benar, grammar, kayak gitu. Nah, nanti lama-lama dalam proses itu kalian juga pede dan juga speakingnya nggak gagap lagi dan grammarnya juga bakal bagus juga gitu menurutku kak.
Okay, thank you.
Okay. Any more question?
Hai, kak. Pertanyaan nih kak. Aku punya pertanyaan.
Yes. Yes.
Kak, gimana sih caranya kita supaya vocabulary kita itu kayak increase gitu, kayak meningkat gitu. Ada kan tips-tips kak kira-kira? Atau mungkin opini dari mana caranya untuk meningkatkan kosakata itu?
Kalau menurutku untuk meningkatkan kosakata adalah kalian banyak baca. Mungkin kalian bisa memulai dengan baca novel bahasa Inggris. Gak usah novel yang ini, gak usah novel yang berat-berat dulu. Kalian bisa baca novel anak atau cerita anak. Dari situ pasti kalian mesti nemu kosakata baru. Dan itu bisa buat belajar. Jadi misal nih, wait. I have novel nih, Diary of Wimpy Kid. Nah, di sini aku belajar kosakata dari novel ini. Jadi ada novel yang jadi ada kosakata baru yang aku nggak ngerti, aku langsung buka kamus. Oh, ternyata artinya itu toh, kayak gitu. Terus yang kedua adalah try to habituate yourself with English, like baca berita dalam bahasa Inggris. Itu juga bisa banget. Jadi, kebiasaan kita sehari-hari itu sebenarnya bisa membangun kita dalam mengembangkan skill bahasa Inggris kita, apalagi kosakata. Maybe some of you juga merasa tiap hari baca berita nih, baca di HP, di BBC misal, atau CNN. Coba ganti CNN Indonesia. Coba ganti misal The Jakarta Post. Mungkin The Guardian yang pakai bahasa Inggris, atau BBC yang pakai bahasa Inggris. Mulai baca di situ, nanti kalian pasti bakal nemu kosakata baru. Pertamanya, I've been there, and I was like, ternyata susah juga bacanya. Tapi, setelah aku baca, dan aku tahu kosakatanya, kayak itu akhirnya menambah kosakata juga. Jadi, selain novel, kalian bisa pakai berita berbahasa Inggris. Yang ketiga, subtitle film. Kalian mesti semua suka kan nonton film. Nah, try to habituate yourself not to use Indonesian subtitle. Pakai English subtitle. Jadi, di English itu kalian tuh perhatiin subtitle-nya. Kalau misalnya ada kosakata yang yang nggak ngerti atau nggak tahu artinya apa, langsung
Say. Kedunge.
Ya, Jel. Jadi gitu. Bisa belajar kosakata dari tiga hal itu. Dan in learning English, please don't be so hard on yourself. Like, jangan ini, cari sesuatu ya gimana kalian belajar itu senang. Misalnya kalian suka baca buku, kalian baca novel, tapi pengen juga belajar bahasa Inggris. Gantilah itu dengan novel bahasa Inggris misal. Kalian suka dengerin lagu. Nah, coba lagu bahasa Inggris yang biasa kalian dengar itu, kalian cari liriknya, terus kalian artiin kira-kira tuh artinya apa sih, kosakatanya apa aja, cari kayak gitu. Make learning as fun as what you want to learn, kayak gitu. Jadi belajarnya jangan dibuat beban, dibuat fun aja. Gitu ya. That's my answer.
Okay,
thank you. Ada yang mau tanya lagi? We still have time. Ya.
Ada masih ada yang mau bertanya kak?
Iya siapa itu?
Kalau orang yang orang Indonesia atau bukan orang native speaker yang ngomong tuh paham. Tapi kalau udah ada yang native speaker itu ngomong tuh udah kayak zzzzz gitu, kak gak tahu ngomong apa.
Wait. Aku tadi yang kalimat awalmu aku nggak begitu dengar.
Saya kan ada masalah selain di grammar, kalau orang Indonesia atau bukan native speaker itu yang ngomong saya paham, tapi kalau yang udah native speaker yang ngomong tuh cuma kayak berdengung kayak zzzz gitu, tak nggak tahu itu ngomong apa. Terus kalau orang ngomong tuh paham,
ngomong apa. Hmm.
Nah, itu kembali lagi ke aku yang bilang tadi. Try to practice more. Jadi, mungkin kamu merasa itu gak jelas ngomong apa karena kamu tidak terbiasa dengan mereka. Jadi, tipsku adalah kalian sering melihat video orang yang ngomongnya cepat. Sering melihat mungkin aksen yang gak jelas. Jadi, dengan itu telingamu akan terbiasa dengan itu. Jadi, mungkin pas kalian lihat video, kalian question yourself. Ini tuh mereka ngomong apa ya? Kayak gitu. Nanti pelan-pelan kalian, misal nih, seminggu sekali nonton kayak gitu. Nanti lama-lama kalian akan terbiasa dan kalian akan paham lama-lama sama omongan mereka. I think that's the tips for me. Terus tadi ada yang tanya Agus ya? Agus, kamu mau tanya, Kak?
Iya, Kak. Saya mau nanya, Kak.
Gimana?
Jadi gini, Kak. Kadang kan pas orang lain ngomong-ngomong bahasa Inggris itu, kita paham apa yang mereka mereka bicarakan. Tapi pas kita menjawab pertanyaan yang mereka sampaikan kepada kita itu, kita jadi ragu. Kira-kira kalau kita ngomong kayak gini, mereka ngerti nggak ya gitu? Gimana tipsnya biar kita bisa ikut bergabung dengan mereka untuk
Jadi ini ya bingung jawabnya ya? Iya kan?
Iya kak.
Okay. The problem that we face adalah sometimes kita tahu mereka ngomong apa, but we don't know how to answer, right? Nah, tipsnya adalah kalian ini, kalau aku itu sering lihat video, misal conversation. Mereka tanya, sebelum ngomong sama orang beneran, kita ngomong sama orang di virtual dulu, di video. Mungkin kalian bisa cari video tentang conversation gitu. Di video itu, aku pernah nemu kayak, dia tanya sama kita. Nah, kita yang jawab. Nah, dengan video, dengan tatap muka kayak gitu, kalian akan terbiasa nanti. Jadi sebelum kalian ngomong sama orang asli, kalian ngomong dulu sama orang di virtual dulu. Nah, biasakan dirimu ngomong, try to speak, try to talk everything, and nanti setelah kalian merasa confident enough, kalian mulai itu bisa nyoba ngomong sama orang asli gitu.
That's
as much for me.
Enak
lagi. Terima kasih.
Thank you.
Ya Allah.
Kak, saya
mau ya, Geraldine.
Thank you for the change. Aku mau nanya ini sih, Kak. Kalau misalnya kita lagi ngomong bahasa Inggris gitu, terus tiba-tiba suka lost word gitu, lupa bahasa Inggrisnya apa ya? Terus atau enggak sadar mau ngomong apa ya lanjutnya? Ada solusinya enggak, Kak? Atau enggak tips? Thank you, Kak.
Okay, thank you, Geraldine. Jadi ini, I've been there also. Tiba-tiba pengen ngomong, tiba-tiba nggak tahu tuh, lupa. Nah, tipsnya adalah jangan ini. Itu kan kalian lagi ngomong sama orang. Jangan sampai kelihatan ini ya. Kamu kayak gugup karena kamu lupa kosakatanya. Menurutku persiapannya adalah ini. Kalian pertama jangan nervous dulu. Kalau misalnya, kalau kalian misalnya lupa di tengah jalan, maybe you can say, I'm sorry, I forgot what I said sama orangnya itu. Atau kalian juga bisa apa ya, kalian bisa bilang topik lain, kayak gitu. Dan untuk menghindari itu adalah kita harus belajar lagi tentang kosakata. Sometimes karena kita lupa, kita itu lupa karena kita tidak terbiasa. Karena tidak terbiasa kan dengan itu. Nah, akhirnya kita harus terbiasa. Jadi harus banyak membaca. Jadi nanti setelah itu jadi habit, dan speaking itu juga jadi habit, itu bakal kalian nggak bakal lupa gitu sama kosakatanya. Itu.
Okay, thank you, Kak.
Thank you. Anything else? Maybe you guys have some suggestion for this course.
Hello, Kak. May I ask something?
Yes.
Well, actually, I just came in like a few minutes ago, so I think someone already asked this same question. But could you please tell me like how to improve our grammar's ability while we are speaking? Because sometimes I find it hard to speak. Especially like next week, I will have like IELTS test, so I think I really need to improve my grammar. Thanks.
Mm-hmm. Okay, Satria, can you please repeat your first question, your first sentence?
So could you please explain to me how to improve our grammar while we are speaking?
Mm-hmm. Okay, thank you. So I think untuk melatih grammar di speaking adalah, satu, kalian harus lihat video speaking yang in a formal way, like di formal occasions, for example. Karena it's different if you speak formally and informally, right? So in order to improve your grammar in speaking, you have to watch those video and practice and imitate them. Jadi meniru gitu. Or maybe I think it's kind of crazy, but sometimes I speak to myself like really. Jadi kayak ngomong-ngomong sendiri gitu. Try to speak sendiri if you don't have partner. Nah, kayak gitu nanti kamu bisa itu ngerekam suaramu dan kamu dengerin. Nah, kalian di situ bisa menilai kira-kira speakingku udah bagus belum ya? Kira-kira kalau aku ngomong kayak gini, grammarku udah bagus belum ya? Jadi gitu. Combine speaking lesson and also grammar lesson first, and then try to speak. Kalau misalnya dia ngomong sendiri, direkam, terus kamu dengerin Satria. It helps a lot. Okay, good luck.
Kak, do you have any great suggestion? Do you have like a suggestion what YouTube channel that has really good English video for me to watch?
Okay, I think it's not for Satria. Mungkin semuanya. Maybe you can watch TED Talks. TED, TED Talks. Nah, di situ ada speech orang-orang yang terkenal. Dan I think isinya juga bagus. I think isinya bagus juga untuk didengerin. So maybe you can watch that. It's good.
Thanks a lot, Kak.
Okay, good luck for your test. Okay, guys, it's already 5:00. I think that's all for today's class. Thank you so much. I do happy to see your enthusiasm. I do happy to see you guys speaking in this class. I hope we can meet next week, okay?
Thank you, Kak.
Okay.
Thank you, Kak.
Thank you, Kak.
Thank you so much, Kak.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, Kak.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, everyone.
Thank you.
Thank you and see you, Kak. Thank you and see you.
Thank you, Kak. Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you. Have a nice day, Kak. Thank you.
Mm-hmm.